Hello and welcome back to iGCSE Success, a channel dedicated to everything first language English. And if you are new here, welcome. I post content here on YouTube to help prepare students for their Cambridge First Language English exam. I'd like to say that I post content here on YouTube at least once a week, but I probably would be lying. However, I try to jump on as often as I can. I know high school can be a difficult 5 years for many students, particularly during those intense 2 years of doing your iGCSE. So if I can make that journey, that process a little bit easier, then with this channel, I'm doing something right. And as mentioned in my previous video, this is going to be a three-part series. If you've not checked out my previous video, I will link it up here. In this video, I look at the writer's effect question, and today's video is all about that dreadful summary question. In the next week or so, I will also be going through the March 2020 paper, guys. The March 2020 paper, it is finally here. Here's a sneak preview. So without further ado, let's get on with today's video. And I'm going to call this video, How to Get 15 out of 15 for the summary writing question. Now let's start with the basics. What is a summary? Put simply, a summary is a shortened version of the text you have been given. Now this could be a fiction piece or a non-fiction piece, but it includes the main ideas only. Now let's look at some of the core skills needed to be able to summarize successfully. The first skill is being able to identify and track the key points from a text. And as a rule of thumb for iGCSE, this is usually about 10 points, but more on that later. You also need to be able to synthesize ideas. And what I mean by this is that you need to organize similar ideas which address the focus of the question. Now, the third skill is being able to express these ideas in your own words where appropriate. And again, more on that later. Now, number four is adopting a suitable style for your summary. Remember, it's objective and it's written in third person. Now, the last skill is being able to produce a summary which is clear and concise. And remember, you only have 120 words. And it's probably important to note that whilst other questions do have suggested word counts, it's only the summary question which stipulates that students mustn't go over the 120 word limit. So now that we know the skills, let's take a look at the 2020 specimen paper, and I will pose the summary question here. And don't worry if you suddenly blinked and found the paper had disappeared from your screen. I will be going through it in approximately 30 seconds. Now there are a few important things to note. So if you have some paper nearby and a pen, get some of these things down. Now it used to be the case that Cambridge would ask students to summarize one idea from the text. Now they're moving towards asking students to summarize two ideas from the text, arguably making the summary question that much more challenging. And that's certainly true for the 2020 specimen paper. Let's read it. Okay, so what you are seeing on your screens now is the summary question from the 2020 specimen paper. Now this is readily available. However, for your convenience, I will leave a link in the description bar. But let's take a read of the question. Read text B, waking the baby mammoth in the insert, and then answer question 1F on this question paper. And that question is, according to text B, what made Luba, I think that's pronounced, such a remarkable and precious scientific specimen? And what did scientists hope to discover by studying her? You must use continuous writing, not note form, and use your own words as far as possible. Your summary should not be more than 120 words. And then, of course, there's 10 marks for the reading and 5 marks for the quality of your writing. Now, of course, there are 10 marks for the reading. So when students are given a question which asks them to summarize two ideas, I always recommend them finding 5 ideas for each part of the question. So what that means for you is reading the text, understanding the text, and eventually highlighting 10 ideas from the text. It's also important to note that Cambridge requires students to write in continuous prose and not note form. It's imperative that your ideas are well organized, they use appropriate discourse markers to link and develop your ideas, for example. And as mentioned earlier in this video, you need to be able to express the ideas from the text in your own words where appropriate. And what I mean by this is that if a writer has used, I don't know, adjectives, for example, you would be expected to use synonyms for those adjectives. Technical terms, for example, you would not be expected to use your own words. And of course, there are 5 marks for the writing, so it's really important that you are able to adopt a suitable style. Your writing is formal, you use appropriate vocabulary choices, appropriate sentence structures, etc. Now let's look at the official mark scheme and see how your work is going to be graded. Hi guys, so what you are looking at now is the mark scheme for the 2020 paper. So the marks allocated to reading and writing, and as mentioned, you get 10 marks for reading and 5 marks for the writing. And I'm just going to assume that most people watching this video are aiming for top marks. So let's just go through a few skills which Cambridge wants students to be able to demonstrate. So let's have a read of these 3 top bullet points. And these are for the reading marks. So students need to be able to write a very effective response that demonstrates a thorough understanding of the requirements of the task. They need to be able to demonstrate an understanding of a wide range of relevant ideas, which is consistently well focused, and students' points need to be skillfully selected to demonstrate an overview. Put simply, guys, what this means is, are you able to summarize effectively? Are you able to use a range of ideas which are focused on the question? Are your ideas relevant, so no redundant material? Okay, and are you able to, I guess, avoid any careless repetition? And to get top marks for writing, students need to be able to provide a relevant response that is expressed clearly, fluently, and mostly with concision. The response is well organized. The response is in the candidate's own words, where appropriate, using a range of well-chosen vocabulary which clarifies meaning. Spelling, punctuation, and grammar are mostly accurate. So obviously, to get top marks, guys, your response needs to be succinct. And I mentioned about not including any redundant material before. It needs to be well organized. Use your discourse markers, that quite complex skill of being able to synthesize similar ideas together is so important. Appropriate vocabulary choices need to be used, appropriate complex sentences, for example. And lastly, grammatical accuracy is so important if you want to get top marks for the writing. And now the bit you've been waiting for. I'm going to take you through the summary question from the 2020 specimen paper. What you are looking at now is text B from the 2020 specimen paper. I will link this in the description bar should you wish to have a go at this question. As you know, the first step to any question is always reading the text carefully, ensuring you fully understand it. So that's exactly what we are going to do together. We are going to read text B, titled Waking the Baby Mammoth. Now, this text is a review of a television program called Waking the Baby Mammoth, so a piece of non-fiction. Only a handful have been found before, but none like her. Her name is Liuba, a 1-month-old baby mammoth. She walked the tundra about 40,000 years ago, then died mysteriously. Discovered on a riverbank in Siberia, she's the most perfectly preserved woolly mammoth ever discovered. Liuba has mesmerized the scientific world with her arrival, creating headlines across the globe. Waking the Baby Mammoth, a new television program, tells the tale of this single accidental discovery of a frozen baby mammoth in the Siberian tundra, and how the discovery has enriched our understanding of these extinct, magnificent beasts. The program begins with the incredible, fortunate discovery of Liuba by a reindeer herder who feared that disturbing the remains of the dead might lead to a curse. Too often with such findings, the preserved creature would be dug up and sold, leading to irreversible decomposition and the loss of a treasure trove of valuable information. However, the herder had enough foresight to contact authorities, and scientists began the careful retrieval process. Everyone wanted to know how Liuba had died. What could she tell us about life during the Ice Age and the Earth's changing climate? The program follows the scientific process and the hurdles in understanding where Liuba came from and what she can tell us about her Pleistocene life. That being said, apart from scientific experiments involving high-tech bone scans, tissue extraction and dental examinations, the program does not delve too far into the intricate data. We are left wondering whether scientists will be able to extract her DNA and what secrets that might uncover. It's impossible to watch the work on Liuba without sharing the anxiety the scientists must have felt to get it right. The program succeeds brilliantly in bringing drama to quite an amazing story. We are presented with stunning 3D animations of Liuba and her mother. In cinematic form, Liuba is brought to life as an active furry baby mammoth, bouncing along next to scientists as they contemplate the frozen carcass's secrets. The visuals are beautiful, light shines off the baby's fur, and her shadows dance in just the right way to really make her come alive. The program has truly woken the baby mammoth within our minds and hearts, and a little glossary there at the bottom. Okay guys, now that we've finished reading the text, let's just remind ourselves of question one and the foci of question one. So according to text B, what made Liuba such a remarkable and precious scientific specimen, and what did scientists hope to discover by studying her? So remember, we are looking for 10 pieces of evidence, okay? 5 pieces of evidence for the first part of the question and 5 pieces of evidence for the second part of the question. Okay guys, so we are ready to find 5 pieces of evidence for the first part of the question. Now, if you've printed this off, have 2 highlighters ready or 2 different colours. I'm simply going to highlight evidence on the PDF. I'm not going to read the text again, but I'm just going to quickly scan over the text, and I'm going to be looking for anything which I guess suggests Liuba's circumstances are unique, unprecedented, precious, remarkable, as per the question. So straight away, only a handful have been found before. So again, this is sort of suggesting how unique and unheard of Liuba's circumstances are. A 1-month-old baby mammoth, 40,000 years ago. So she's remained frozen for a pretty long time, guys. You might want to look at the mystery behind her death and the fact that she's the most perfectly preserved woolly mammoth ever. So already we've got 1, 2, 3, we've got 4 things already, guys. Now there was something about, here it is. So this reindeer herder finds the remains, and you know, most people would perhaps arguably dig the remains up and sell them for profit. However, he goes through the appropriate authorities, and of course the remains are retrieved in a very sort of careful manner. So I guess the fact that she's not dug up, she's not sold, that is quite unheard of. So that makes it incredibly precious. Do we have enough? I believe so. We've got 5 things. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so the next part of the question asks us to look at what the scientists hoped to discover by studying her. Now let's just have a look towards the later part of the article. I would imagine all of the evidence for the second part of the question is around this area. That usually is the case. Here we go. So everyone wanted to know how Liuba had died. So the mysterious circumstances surrounding her death. So we've got our first thing already. And then following on from that, what can she tell us about life during the Ice Age and the Earth's changing climate? So you could separate those two things if you wanted to. So where Liuba came from? Okay, so tell us more about woolly mammoths and their lives. And let's go with as well, we are left wondering whether scientists will be able to extract her DNA and what secrets that might uncover. Okay guys, I think I've got enough to address the second part of the question. We should end up, hopefully, with 10 quotations. I have pasted the 10 quotes which I will be using, and hopefully this will be far more helpful than me just sticking a model response at the end of the video. So I am going to be typing a response to this question. I'm going to talk you through my thought process, the process that you should go through in order to end up with a succinct response which addresses both parts of the question. Now, the first focus, of course, is why Liuba is such a remarkable and precious scientific specimen. And the second focus is what did scientists hope to discover by studying her? And I'm going to use all 10 quotes, so I end up with 10 points in my summary. Remember, it's only 120 words, and I'm going to do my best to stick to that word count. And I know it's really, really quite difficult. Many, many, many of my students over the years often go over the word count, but you really need to stick to that word count or be slightly under. One or two words over, I don't think it will be a problem, but when you're sort of going into that realm of 130, 140, 150, you're not going to end up with a concise summary. And that's really what Cambridge is asking you to do. Okay, so we are now ready to begin typing up our response. I often get asked about the timings for this question. I think this question isn't too difficult, so you don't want to be spending too much time on it. My students generally get this question finished in about 20 minutes, and that gives them more time for the slightly more challenging questions, such as a writer's effect question, the directed writing question, and obviously they've got all the newer questions to answer as well. Now remember, 120 words, where possible we need to use our own words, and I just want to give you a quick example of that before I start typing my response. Now let's look at some of these quotes. We have a phrase here, only a handful. Okay, so I would imagine Cambridge would want you to find an alternative rather than using only a handful. The fact that Liuba died mysteriously, so finding an alternative adverb for mysteriously. Perfectly preserved, maybe finding an alternative for perfectly. And just where possible, using your own words. Of course, technical terms, scientific terms, Ice Age, for example, you wouldn't be expected to use your own words. So let's have a go at typing a response. And guys, I do apologize if you can hear me typing. As mentioned, I wanted to give you a proper walkthrough to give you my thought process rather than just sticking a model at the end. So I'm going to start with a clear topic sentence. And I guess I'm going to mention, the fact that it's been frozen, preserved for 40,000 years. And that in itself is quite remarkable or quite precious. So let's have a go at doing this. So I'm going to start, and excuse me if I make any glaring typos, I will go back and check them. The discovery of, let's put Liuba's, 40,000 year, year old remains has made her one of the most Let's use remarkable from the question. Remarkable discoveries ever made. So that's my, I guess, clear topic sentence to begin my summary with. And I've already addressed 40,000 years ago, and I guess only a handful as well. What can we put? Let's be a bit more explicit about there only being a handful discovered. So due to there being only a small number of similar findings, let's say the story surrounding, let's not use mysterious, mystifying, that's the only one I can think of presently, I'm quite tired, the mystifying death of Liuba. Let's put in a nice verb, has captivated the world. I like that. Okay, so we've addressed a few things from our five quotations. What's important to note, guys, is that you need to reorganize the ideas. And although these quotes are in chronological order, you don't necessarily need to adopt a chronological approach. Group similar ideas together. Use complex sentences to synthesize ideas. Otherwise, you'll find that you will run out of words. You've only got 120 words, remember. So let's use a connective. Additionally, with Liuba being the best. Okay, so the quote is perfectly preserved. Let's just use best. Best preserved woolly, mammoth ever recorded or discovered. And that, are we on the last quote? Okay, and that her remains were not carelessly extricated and sold for profit. Should we put that? And sold for profit? No, let's just put sold because I'm worried that's a little verbose. Extricated and sold makes her circumstances even more, let's use precious from the question. And there we have it, guys. Already we have addressed those five quotations, and hopefully you've seen that process. Apologies, I've got so much sort of, I've got birds tweeting, I've got a gardener outside, so I do apologize if the audio is not the clearest. But hopefully you can see that I'm grouping similar ideas together. I'm synthesizing ideas, using complex sentence structures. Otherwise, we are going to run out of words. Let's just check. Okay, so 66. We've got a few more words to play with. So the second focus is, what did scientists hope to discover by studying her? So we kind of need to get these five quotations into the rest of our word count. So how can we start? Let's say scientists hope that Liuba, I think that's how you pronounce it, by the way, guys. Scientists hope that Liuba, or let's put Liuba's DNA, would reveal, let's say, unlock a number of clues to not only the circumstances surrounding her death, but to her, let's say,
let's say species and where she came from. Okay, so we've addressed a few bullet points already. Let's use a connective. So furthermore, it was hoped that, it was hoped that her discovery would, I've used unlock already, reveal what life was like. What do we need to address during the Ice Age? Okay, would reveal what life was like during the Ice Age. And which one do we have left? And the Earth changing climate. So how can we incorporate that? I think the suggestion is that the Earth changing climate impacted the woolly mammoths. So let's put like during the Ice Age and how the changing climate impacted this. Right, let's do the word count, guys. 118 words, guys. 118. Now let's just proofread this. I know it was done really quickly. The discovery of Liuba's 40,000, there we go. Whoops. 40,000-year-old remains has made her one of the most remarkable discoveries ever made. Due to there being only a small number of similar findings, the stories surrounding, that's why you have to proofread, guys, surrounding the mystifying death of Liuba has captivated the world. Additionally, with Liuba being the best preserved woolly mammoth ever recorded, and that her remains were not carelessly extricated and sold, makes her circumstances even more precious. Scientists hope that Liuba's DNA would unlock a number of clues to not only the circumstances surrounding her death, but to her species and where she came from. Furthermore, it was hoped that her discovery would reveal what life was like during the Ice Age and how the changing climate impacted this. There we go, guys. There is my summary. We've addressed all 10 points. We've got a range of points. It's under the word count. We've synthesized ideas. It's an appropriate tone. We've used connectives. And ultimately, guys, that is what you want to achieve. Remember, we are not necessarily rewording every single word. Look for any kind of descriptive language, any kind of adjectives that are used, and then use your own words where appropriate. And that's it from me, guys. Again, I hope this video has been useful. My next video is going to be breaking down the directed writing question. So if that interests you, like, subscribe, comment, do all of that jazz. And I will be back very soon. Until next time, bye-bye.